Al Murray has ditched his...
Sorry about that. Looking at my Twitter feed. Everyone's going nuts today.
It doesn't matter what I say. I could just be saying anything.
Trying to do a link, Piers.
You could say anything.
But they're waiting for me to address the nation.
Oh, that's right, yeah. And then, so then Muttley joins a grateful nation.
Dastardly first, Muttley second.
Yeah, but everyone loved Muttley.
Anyway, go on, off of you.
Al Murray has ditched his pub landlord alter ego for a new show which hopes to discover the truth behind England's greatest rivalries.
And Al joins us now. The show is called Why Does Everyone Hate the English? Did you find out why everyone hates English?
No, not really. we went to Scotland, Ireland, Wales, France and Germany, and we found that there, in each country, there are very different relationships.
Who hates English the most of those?
I would say, if you had to go 1 to 5, top... Scotland is number one.
I knew it would be Scotland.
Wales and Ireland joint second.
Yeah.
France fourth, Germany fifth, because the Germans don't even give us a minute's thought.
You're so
really?
Right.
Is that right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We are obsessed with the Germans.
We are obsessed
with the Germans. Don't even
absolutely.
Think about us.
And in lots of ways. Billy Connolly once famously said that in Scotland, everyone's thinking about the English, and in England, no one's thinking about the Scots, right? When you go to Germany, it's like being a Scotsman in England. The Germans, you have to say to the German, if you ask a German, what do you think of the English? And then, oh, I don't know, I haven't really given it any thought lately.
Sunbeds?
Yeah, exactly. Well, they sort of don't even know about the sun lounger thing. They don't know. We're not on their radar. We're not the big fixture.
The pub landlord, of course, part of his success was the sort of anti-PC stuff that he would go on. And this is a raging, ongoing debate now. Yesterday, we had a top astronaut in America, Scott Kelly, apologising for quoting Sir Winston Churchill because Twitter has decided Winston Churchill's the devil, and if you even quote him about being magnanimous in victory, you must be hounded off.
Because he was actually a xenophobic racist rather than a war hero.
What do you make
hero,
of the way these debates are now going?
Well, the problem with history, and this is sort of one of the things we investigate in this programme, is that if you reduce it down to binaries, you'll get nowhere. Mm. Churchill was a complex man and a man of his time. There's no other way of looking at him like that. Mm. And he said some juicy quotable things, and he said some other things that you know that would be unacceptable now. So if you're determined to boil it down into a binary,
where is the line for someone like you, who's a comedian who's out there all the time, making people laugh as in this ever-changing, fast-moving world?
Yeah.
Right? Where is the line between what some call overt political correctness and actually just being a more decent human being?
Oh, Piers. I mean, you know, we've only got a 3-minute interview here to discuss that. I actually think there's the fast-moving world of Twitter, and then there's all the people who aren't on Twitter, who aren't engaged
in... 97%.
Exactly, who aren't engaged in this whirlwind, this endless setting of standards and boundaries. And the audiences I play to aren't as eyes down on all this stuff as
do you agree?
More maybe tolerant. They're more tolerant.
And they're much more tolerant.
Yeah.
And they're also much more inclined to go, whatever.
Yeah. Do you agree with Ricky Gervais's sort of basic tenet, which is you should be able to laugh at almost everything?
Well, yes, you should be able to laugh, but the almost is doing all the work there, isn't it?
Right.
Yes,
it's the almost.
So
where do you think
where do you think the comedy line should be drawn? What wouldn't you joke about?
Well, if you can make that, this is such a hornet's nest, such a complex thing, because if you when people take offence and they say they're offended, what they're doing is they're making something active out of something passive. If you don't find something funny, if you say, "Oh, I don't find that funny," you sound like a party pooper, you sound boring, you sound dull. But if you say I'm offended by that, you have an active.
You're a campaigner.
You're active rather than passive. Yeah. And I think that's why the attraction for some people when they say I'm offended by that, they mean I don't think that's funny. Mm. But it's a way of making it more sort of punchy. Mm.
We've had a debate this morning about whether someone like Taylor Swift,
yeah,
a big celebrity, huge amount of influence, should now get political. She's decided to. I think I know why. Piers has a completely different view about why. You're a celebrity who's gone into politics, notably, not terribly successfully.
Well,
it
was entirely successful.
Yeah, it was.
I wasn't interested in winning the seat.
No.
I wanted people to vote. Mm. And
that's what Taylor Swift has done, because apparently voter registration.
But if all she said was, hey, kids, go out and vote, that's one thing. But she took a position. Well, here's the so what I think. If you're a comedian and part of your stock in trade is political jokes, that's fine, right? No one, I think that's perfectly consistent. When you've got literally tens of millions of impressionable young girls and they're on all from families on all sides of the political divide.
Yeah.
Is it a smart move to come out and basically in one stroke, after 10 years of avoiding it, say, I'm with that lot and not with you lot?
Well, are you asking an artist not to be true to themselves?
Is she being true to herself,
yeah,
or is she,
yeah, if she's
or
saying,
is she running away from a Twitter mob who've been harassing her for two years
defending,
about not opposing
but
Trump
she's
in
defending
public,
LGBTQ rights, which is a huge part of her audience.
If that's what she thinks she should do, then she should do it. Mm. I think if you're assuming that artists should be true, you know, you should be true to yourself. If it then doesn't work, that's your problem, right? But you're asking... If you're saying she's doing it as a calculation, I kind of don't. I don't buy that.
Sean Walsh,
yes.
A fellow comedian, rather has taken the shine off the Strictly Fairy Tale this
has
morning.
Has he?
Yeah.
I thought he was doing the fairy tale.
I thought he was doing his solemn duty of getting off with one of the dancers.
Oh, dear.
Would you ever do it?
Oh, God, no.
For that reason?
Yeah, I think my raw sexiness on the dance floor would be too much.
I mean,
think of the headlines.
Why does everyone hate the English? Went out last night.
But it's on catch-up, so you can
on
watch.
The History Channel. Google it. Okay, yeah. Google
great
it.
Great to see you, Al, as always.
A pleasure.